Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing well. So in this video, I am going to do this section of this page here. I did in the two previous videos, this cake here. And so this is taken from Fairy Touch of Magic, Klara Markova. Right, so without further ado, let's get started. I'm going to color this pink. So I thought I would use the base blush pink. And the cups, the saucer and the cup. So very, very lightly. I thought it would match this raspberry and the butterfly. I was thinking, you know, I was contemplating on what color to use for the saucer and the cup. So I thought pink would be good if you know, it matches with the strawberry. Raspberry. Yeah. It's a bit tricky to color in, you know, in the spine of the book, but press it down a little bit. It's kind of tricky to, you know, actually color towards the end. They should have just made the picture smaller to the side, but but anyway, this is just a filler page picture. And I would give it a bit of a, you know, I blend it in with deco pink. Now a bit of a shadow beads, which I would use where's my French grey? Yeah, French grey 10. No, not French grey 10. I think I'll use this one, just pink. like that. I'm gonna blend it in with the deco pink. I think I'm just gonna use a bit of a white as well, but I make sure it's the white is clean. Else you're gonna have streaks of other colors, so I'm gonna blend it in with everything with white. Yeah, like that. And maybe I thought I would just give it a tiny bit of a, you know, darker hue, crimson lake. So shadow bits here, the raspberry color. And blend it in with this color, deco pink. Right, and the cup as well. So I'm just going to use the same just now, blush pink. Alright, so now I'm going to, you know, give it a bit of a shadow. I'm going to use 50% warm grey on this section here. So there was some speed up a little bit. Blend it in with blush pink. Yeah, so I am going to add a little bit of a warm grey in this section here. Blend it in with the blush pink. And pink. And I thought I would just leave this part whitish. This fruit fly wants to join us. Stuck and everything, and I would say this is just a fruit tea or just, you know, some tea beverage. And the flour here. Later I'll just blend it in with the white, I would say. Yeah, I'll just blend it in with white. And the leaves for the flower, I would use chartreuse first. Lime peel. And Persian green. I would color this as a yellow flower, sunburst yellow. Blend it in with lemon yellow. And the middle part there, I'm going to use lime peel. And golden rod for this flower bits here. Right, I'm just going to leave bits of white here. And I'm going to use goldenrod for the tea base, the beverage. Color it in with yellow ochre, give it a bit of a yellowish hue to it. And the sides, I would color it with sienna brown. Blend it in with the yellow ochre. Right, and the spoon, I'm just also going to use, you know, bake it a golden spoon. So yellow ochre. Sienna brown. For the shadow beads. Dark umber. Blend it back out with yellow ochre. And it looks much better like that. And this one, the leaves, lime peel. It's not going to be that green because it's like, you know, a little bit like a tea leaf sort of. And I blend it in with yellow ochre. And the ribbon, I'm going to color the ribbon red, crimson red. very lightly. And I'm gonna use this Crimson Lake for this shadow bits here. Give it a bit of a warm gray shadow. Raspberry. -50% warm gray. Just for the shadow bits. Blend it out with a raspberry. And poppy red. I'm going to use a bit of a decor pink to blend it in. Do a bit of a touch up. pink. It the sides with white. Yeah, and this part here, trimmings, I'm just going to color it in gold, so I'll be back in a bit. Okay, I've got my gold, my Calero gold. I'm going to use this Digger gold, and I've prepared it beforehand. And I'm just going to, you know, color these sides here, these trimmings as gold. You could use pencil to make it look gold, but I am lazy, so I'm using the shortcut. Anyway, this is just like a small part of the picture, so I am giving it the gold trimming. You could probably use the same color as the spoon if you want to make it gold with colored pencil. Just going to add a bit more water. Oh, I have touch pen for this. It looks like I'm going to go buy another set of gold paint. I've hit pen on two colors. I've got, still got a lot of paint yet. Yeah, and the dots. Touch of gold. There. Yeah. Clean my brush, put the gold aside, and yeah, so I would say it's done. See, so I've got this section here. I'm just going to zoom. Yeah, I don't have to zoom out. All right, so yeah, I've got this filler page done. Thanks for watching. So till the next video, take care and happy coloring. Bye bye. If you like videos like this, though, give me a cheeky thumbs up and subscribe if you have not already for more contents like this. Bye bye. Thank you.